and welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe.
What you got, Lee?
What I got is it's a site that I feel like we should have talked about last year when we were talking about security.
Right.
This site deals with safe sites. It's mentored sites. Sites have been submitted and checked.
Okay.
And it's a safe way to surf the web for kids.
All right.
In fact, even for, I guess, some adults, because it has safe shopping sites.
Oh,
so you don't accidentally get.
So these are pre-filtered places that have been verified to be trustworthy by who? Experts?
Well, actually, they go over things, and then you can actually volunteer to be part of their program.
So it's really just average everyday people.
Yeah, but it's a download. Uh-huh. It's free.
Right.
Free is good.
Right.
Free is very good. So, and you know, I tested a few times this summer. Very good. And WOT.
So, in terms of a download, what happens after you download it?
It's going to show up as an icon on your browser.
Okay.
And if you go to an inappropriate site, it's going to flash
red. So, it won't block you from going to that site, but it'll actually alert you that you're on a site that's not trusted.
You can actually set up so it will block you from it. And then the alert shows up to show you why you're not going anywhere.
Okay.
So, I was pretty impressed with it. It's free, so it's worth the check for somebody who wants to help their kids have a safe experience on the web.
Very, very important, parents out there, that you're supervising your children, especially younger children. even your never mind. Okay, now we're going to talk a lot about this though, and you were showing me this before, and this is pretty cool.
This is cool. It's got a lot of stuff on it. Right now, I'm on the Bing Maps site.
Okay, and that's Bing.com.
Maps.bing.com, or you can go to Bing.com/maps. Either way.
Okay. So, and this is owned by Microsoft, and with all of Microsoft's resources and technologies behind it.
We looked at this last year, and I was like,
way cool. There's a lot of really cool stuff.
There's some cool stuff.
And it's like, competitor for Google Maps, right? Or Yahoo Maps,
But I'm a Google Map user.
Sure, me too.
I love it.
Right.
But this could actually woo me away. This has got some neat stuff on it.
Sweet.
We're going to look at this, and I'm going to show you how to get to it. Right here, you're at the map, so and you can see we've got a map here and everything. And it's like whoop-de-doo. We've seen maps before.
Yes, we have seen maps before.
But on the left side down here, it says "Get More and Try It Now." I'm going to click on this, and when I do that, some things on the map actually change, and you're not going to see them obvious immediately. But up here, there's a 3D experience. So if I click on something, we talked about Photosynth last year.
Right, and Photosynth is a way for people to upload images, and then the technology stitches them together to make it look like a three-dimensional space that you're in.
So, you know, I clicked on this, and this is going to go out and grab some things for me. This is a Photosynth that came up.
Okay.
And we actually picked up a sidebar in there. It's not the one I wanted to get. Let's see. We'll click on this. This is a Photosynth made with 112 pictures. It's an undersea playroom, and I guess this is in somebody's house.
Really?
Notice how it laid the map down.
I know. I like that part about Bing Maps. It gets what's called a bird's eye view. It's better than the satellite view you get in Google Maps, which is straight down. The one that Bing has is a combination of satellites and pictures taken from airplanes.
Now, when you make a Photosynth, it's made up of different pictures, and you see as I roll around, I get the different frames that's made from.
Right.
And if I click on one, I actually can, move into
cool.
that picture.
So and you can locate these on the Bing map.
Yeah.
They're all over the country, and they're just a lot of fun.
Now, in the lower left, you see a thing that says "More Map Apps." Okay.
Right.
Get free.
Okay.
I'm going to click on this, and this is where it gets dangerous because this is cool stuff. It's going to bring up a list of apps. And the one I showed you earlier that I really liked was Friends. Let's see if we can find that again. There it is. This is my Friends.
Okay.
And this interfaces with Facebook. So I'm already logged into it there, and I'm just going to click Connect. And it's going to come up and ask me to do my password again.
Okay, so you have to have a Facebook account in order to have Friends, obviously, and you have to have the ability to log into your own Facebook account. But once you do that, once your login is complete, Well, now what's going to happen?
Well, watch what happens
here.
It starts to populate my friends in
the
part that's on the map.
That's cool.
And you see the plus here?
Right. Oh, wow.
That explodes into all the people that are in that area.
That's cool.
So, this is nice.
Yeah, buh-buh-buh-buh.
And if I zoom in and drag this back over here, the closer you get, the more it breaks it down for you so you can see where these different people are.
Right. That's so pretty cool.
I see Mike Edgley or Bob LaRocca, Scott Blake.
Well, all your friends live in Palm Beach County, Lee, or do you have friends elsewhere?
Well, that's neat. Now, what I want you to watch is the left side over here. You see the list of friends over there?
That's all your friends. You don't have very
many
friends.
That's the ones that show on the map. If I zoom in more, there's only three people left there.
Okay, because those are all your friends in Jupiter.
Likewise, if I zoom out, my list on the left is going to get larger.
Right.
Because I'm showing 99 of them that show up here.
So the list on the left only shows you the visible friends that you have on your map.
In fact, the bottom there says show all 123. Now, I've got more than 123 friends on Facebook, but this is a list of the people that have, A, allowed this, and B, have their address in there. Not necessarily your whole address, but their
but
city.
Right, at least the city. I mean, I think we looked at that before. A lot of people only put the name of the city in. So you want, if you're looking in locally, you may not see everybody, or they might be lumped in one location, even though they're kind of spread out.
And the neat thing is if you click on one of these people, Joe Pasco is one of my ex-high school students at Twin Lakes, and you could actually go in and write on their wall or open their profile.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
So that's just one of many of these apps that are on here.
That's awesome.
There's a Twitter app, weather apps, all kinds of things. I recommend you go try it, play with it, have a great time with
it. Bing.com, and all those apps look like a lot of fun.
Yeah, okay. That's it for this week on Palm Breeze
Cafe.
Fast. Yeah, it was just done.
Just like that. We'll come back next week. And
next week,
we're going to
be doing words. We're going to be looking at programs, apps, and websites for fun vocabularies.
Word.
So we'll see you next week.
Word.